Welcome to episode 69, you said 69, of Driver's Seat Blog Radio, and as always, I am your host, David G. Firestone. So I find myself in an unusual position this week. I've used up all of the news stories I had in reserve for last week, and nothing really major's happened, at least that's not really worth talking about. So I wasn't sure how to approach this week's podcast. Well, I'm going to take a snow day, and I'm fully aware of the fact that it's the 1st of May as I'm recording this, but I don't care. It's a snow day. From here on out, snow days will be any time where I don't have my normal amount of work to work around, and I'm just going to talk about whatever is on my mind, and it's not going to be controversial. It's not going to be dragging on jobs or news or that kind of stuff. Just fun. Because snow days are always fun. So I've got a lot of people at the house right now. My cousin came over from Minnesota, had to quit a very bad job, so he's been staying with me, and his cat is with him, and our cats do not get along, which is never a good sign when you're going downstairs and all you hear is, like a cat making that noise. But maybe, and I'll tell you this, I came home from work and my cousin's cat is sitting in a rocking chair, and I go over to it and I let her sniff my hand, I scratch her ears, and she lets me do it. She's not running away or hissing, so it's good that she's trusting me. And then I look over at my cat Zoe, and she's giving me this look like, you piece of crap. You piece of crap. Just that insane jealousy. But she did come in and get my attention a little later, so I think all is forgiven between us. What else can I talk about? I'll talk about this. I have 3 YouTube channels. This one, DGF29 Productions, my main channel, and DGF2099V2, my second channel. The primary videos that I have on there as of now are wherever I do a thunderstorm video, and my pinball videos with my 1977 Cosmic Pinball Machine. I've spent the better part of a week fixing a lot of the issues that have been plaguing it. I'm not going to get the pop bumpers working. That's just how it is. But I did get the lights fixed. I did fix a lot of the issues, and it's working much better now. I don't have to shake it to get the pinballs in the right position, which I had to. So that's a lot of fun. Here's a fun fact. Did you know that between 1976 and 1980, Brunswick Bowling made pinball tables? Yep. Brunswick. So I'm also working on another set of videos, which I'm not going to talk about just yet because I haven't gotten around to shooting the test videos yet. I'm about 80% complete, but I'm not going to talk more about it till I'm 100% complete. Let me see. I probably should have put some more thought into this, but I've just been running around like a headless chicken for the past, like, week. I had to move my YouTube production day from Monday, May 1st to Saturday the 29th because of a few issues, so I didn't get a chance to come up with any kind of note on this. So yeah, just a little bit of insight into my existence at the moment. I'm going to pull up some notes here. Give me 1 second. Do-do-do-do. Don't really have anything in the pipeline. Thought I did. Okay, I'm gonna pause it right here. I'm gonna just come up with something, and I'll be right back. And I'm back. I had to take a few minutes just to look something up, because I've been wanting to talk about this for a while. I had done some notes, I just couldn't find them. I'd saved them in the wrong folder, being the idiot that I am. So the new season of Beavis and Butthead, at the time of recording, has just started. I like this new version of Beavis and Butthead. The 2011, I don't know if you can call it, it's a reboot in a certain sense, but I'll discuss that in a little bit. This new version of Beavis and Butthead started with the Beavis and Butthead Do the Universe and with season 2 on Paramount Plus. It's really entertaining. The characters are still good. And they also do, they have a multiverse thing where it's Beavis and Butthead got shot through a wormhole in 2022, and then there's Beavis and Butthead are middle-aged and still living in Highland. I like this. It's like the old Beavis and Butthead. It's kind of, it works. It's hilarious. And the old school duel are still entertaining too. But I was thinking about this. So this timeline of Beavis and Butthead starts in 1998, just after the original season ended, original series ended. They get shot to 2022, and now they're living in modern times. So what is the deal with the 2011 reboot? Is it still canon? Is it its own timeline? I don't know. And that's the thing. It was obviously Beavis and Butthead are still in their current universe. But it's been updated to include new things such as, you know, my judge said he was never going to reference social media on the 2011 reboot, yet he did. At least once, he mentioned YouTube. They were watching the Jersey Shore, they were watching the new MTV reality shows. But in this particular timeline, with this new series, it's almost like, was it a dream sequence? Was the 2011 reboot a dream sequence? Was it... I mean, and I understand that I'm probably thinking way too into this, but a lot of the fans are wondering too, so it's not just me. And again, I did sort of like the 2011 reboot, but it did lack some things. So, I've babbled on enough. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to take a break, and then I'm going to debut a brand new segment that I've been working on. I'll probably have to come up with a replacement segment, but this is going to work, and I'll be right back. This week we have another edition of Tailgating Time. I'm bringing this segment back with a new setup, which I call the Under 20 Under 20 Meal. What is an Under 20 Under 20 Meal? Well, I will be preparing a meal to consume while watching racing under the following parameters. Number 1, no pre-made, frozen, boxed, or canned meals unless they are part of a larger recipe. The above sets of meals can be combined if they are used as ingredients. All dishes must contain at least 3 ingredients, Total meal cost cannot exceed $20. Total meal prep and cook time cannot exceed 20 minutes. So for the first episode, I will be making a 7-cheese Alfredo pizza. Many people think that cheese pizza is the most bland and boring kind of pizza because it's, well, a pizza with no real toppings. On the other hand, cheese pizza does have its fans, and I'm one of them. I think cheese pizza is highly underrated, and I think cheese pizza is rather delicious. It's simple, it's filling, and it tastes great. Also, it's a good test bed for trying new hot sauces. While it can be seen as one note, it can be jazzed up with new strategies. One night, after a few drinks, I made this kind of pizza, and I've been making it ever since because I like it so much. For this recipe, you will need the following ingredients. A 16-ounce jar of Signature Select 4-cheese Alfredo pasta sauce, $2.49, and contains the following cheeses: Parmesan, Ricotta, Romano, and Provolone. You will need an 8-ounce bag of Lucerne Italian-style 6-cheese blend, and contains the following cheeses: Mozzarella, Provolone, Asiago, Parmesan, Romano, and Fontina. And for the last ingredient, you will need a 10-ounce Signature Select pizza crust. I went with thin because it was the only one available for $3.99, so we're very much under our $20 limit. Now, in total, between the sauce and the cheese blend, there are a total of 7 different cheeses that will be in this pizza: Parmesan, Ricotta, Romano, Provolone, Mozzarella, Asiago, and Fontina. Now, to prepare this pizza, you will need to follow these instructions. Preheat the oven to 450 degrees and spray pizza pan on baking sheet with nonstick spray. 2. Remove pizza crust from wrapper and follow instructions for use. 3. Cover crust with Alfredo sauce followed by cheese. Take the tray, place it in the oven, and bake for 8 to 10 minutes. This pizza will fill you up and tickle your taste buds. You will never see cheese pizza the same again after trying this, and neither will your guests.